Hello, veteran 0121 here. Welcome back. This is another episode of Final Fantasy 15. And in this episode, I'm going to continue to explore Hammerhead, although I think I did most of the exploring in the last video. I think I am going to accept at least one hunt from this guy over here, the level 2 hunt. Other than that, I don't think I'm going to accept too many more. I don't know, if hunts are convenient and easy, then
order away.
I'll pick them up.
Y'all see anything you like?
Otherwise, I'm not going to worry about most of the hunts.
Appreciate it.
But I kind of need the gill.
Take care.
Huh. Alright, so basically, I should probably go over the menu. This here's the map. You can access the map from your menu. You can zoom out with the right stick. You can look around with the left stick. And you can highlight different things on your map to see what they are. Stuff like that. That's where I have to go for the hunt, apparently. I don't have to go too far, so I might as well just get it over with. In fact, I should just do that first. And, oh yeah, then we have our quests. And if you're at, if you want to actually highlight the quest that you want to do, you just, you know, you just highlight it. You just hit the X button, and when the arrow highlights it, that's the one that you'll actually be able to see on your map. So if you're confused as to where your quest objective is on your map, basically that's how you highlight it. So it's a lot like the Western RPGs that I've played in the past. So there you go. That's how you switch your active quest. As far as the gear is concerned, you can control all Noctis' stuff. Plus, you can equip accessories, and you can also change their attire. And the attire in this game actually affects their stats. Like I could wear the fatigues here with no jacket, get a little boost to attack and defense and magic, but I don't have as much HP. Right now, I think I'd rather prioritize HP. Staying alive is a lot more important, so I'm gonna keep the jacket on. Okay, so as far as weapons, engine blade, there we go. Oh, wait, no, it's already equipped. Javelin. No daggers, huh? I don't have a fourth weapon, that's fine. Then we have the ascension thing that I showed off. Yeah, Noctis and his friends each possess their own unique skills. They become more proficient as they gain experience in their respective areas of expertise. So Noctis, he's the fisherman. Gladiolus, he is good at exploring the wild. I'm not really sure how that levels up. I guess the more you explore, like, off the beaten path is how you level that up. Ignis, he levels up whenever you cook at camp with him. And Prompto, he levels up by taking pictures. He's kind of like he's just a weird dude that likes to take a lot of pictures. Selfies and all that shit. Yeah, see? And you get like different skills whenever you level up this stuff. Potion provider, I guess. Sometimes he'll find random potions. And Ignis will get new recipes. Prompto, he'll get different lenses for his camera, I guess. I don't know. I'm not really sure what the hell the point of Prompto taking pictures is. I have heard that that has something to do with something later on in the game, but I have no idea. Here we can craft spells. Right now I only have one magic flask, so I can only equip one character with a set of spells that I craft. I don't have any drawed elements, so I can't make any spells at the moment. And we can check or order items. You got your items separated by category. You got your restoratives, your wait a minute, I do have daggers? The fuck? I was looking for daggers before. Anyways, yeah, you got your accessories, your ingredients, treasures that you can sell for gil. So it's kind of like in Final Fantasy XII, you know, when you get loot from monsters, you can sell it for gil. I don't think there's any crazy bizarre crap like in that game. That's kind of a nightmare. If you remember the loot system in Final Fantasy XII, you know, getting that bizarre shit. Then we have leisure goods. Some of these have to do with like fishing, and I think pretty much all this shit is fishing. And then we have key items, which we need for a certain quest. Archives. Oh, this wasn't here. Okay, this must have been added with the day one patch. Yeah, I was playing the game for like 20 hours without the day one patch. I didn't even know it existed. Okay, so we can look at all the different recipes. That's quaint. Fishes. Again, I'm not really going to spend too much time with the mini games and that kind of stuff. I'm going to wait till after the credits roll to start doing side quests. For the most part.
Let's hit it.
Ignis! Shake a leg!
On my way.
Yeah, man, hurry up.
Man, it's hot.
Then lose the jacket.
No, not losing the jacket. Sorry, Gladio. Our hunt marks up here are going to be marked with weird symbols above them, I guess. That's how you know that's enemies you got to kill for a hunt. So let's kill them.
Got all those arms at your disposal. Use
them.
Chomp, chomp.
How about this?
Done in a minute.
Time to spare.
Pronto, double time it.
Crush him!
Count on it!
Yeah, these fuckers are everywhere, man.
Don't wear yourself out like that. Take cover and rest up.
Problems? Nothing you want to worry about, touch you.
I can't keep the runs in my sights!
Pronto! Stop bitching! Start killing!
No use hanging around here.
So yeah, you get different grades depending on how well you did in battle. You get more stealth if you do more like behind kills, and the more you dodge and parry, that's how you get your that's how you determine your defense rating. And you want good ratings in all three of those categories because you get more experience points. Oh, and experience points in this game only apply to you and when you rest. I'll go over a little bit how that works later when it's more pertinent.
Sometimes I wonder if we'll ever sit inside that beautiful car again.
Sitting most of the day was pretty nice.
Napping was even better.
Me up, dude.
So how's it going, boys? No surprises.
All right, that was fun.
What can I do you for? Want to help out with some varmints?
Nah.
If y'all liked it, come on back.
Whatever it does, it must be important.
Looks like we found our first targets.
Yep.
Ready, knocked.
I'm already liking this third control scheme a lot better than what I was using before, type A or whatever it was. I didn't like it because whenever you would be holding down square button, you can't touch the right stick. You can't touch the right analog stick, so you can't control the camera while doing that, which really stinks. Ooh, there we go.
Alright. We'll be done in no time.
Let's get on with it.
So, where are we headed anyway?
Nowhere until the repairs are done. Then we head for Galdin Quay.
Then after that, we hop a boat, and before you know it, lover boy's hitched.
Wait for car repairs, then wedding bells in the air. Got it.
Actually, you know what? I don't think I... Yeah, that's right. Circle button for techniques. Yeah, I don't know why this goddamn headset, the fucking side tone likes to go out on it. It shuts itself off, and then the side tone goes out, and then I gotta stop recording just to turn the side tone back on. It is fucking ridiculous. What's this about?
What happened here?
A telegraph pole's been split in two. And not just this one, either.
The hell do you think did this?
Hard to say. Natural disaster, perhaps?
You sure? The hammerhead doesn't have a scratch on it.
Maybe a huge monster came and knocked him down.
It better not be the varmint Cindy was talking about.
Anyways, what I was saying was, hey, just hold down R2 to sprint. And I guess I might as well show this off, although I'm not really going to be taking advantage of it, because I don't really think it's necessary. Plus, I just hate the annoying-ass meter that's, like, above Noctis's head. But yeah, you get the stamina meter here, right? And as soon as it gets down to, like, right about where the S is, you hit the button again. You can basically do this to sprint indefinitely. It's kind of hard to time though when you can't see the stamina meter. And there I fucked it up somehow, but yeah, like I said, I'm not really gonna take. So it doesn't distract me. Getting kind of late.
Man can walk.
Our Crown City upbringing didn't prepare us for this.
You know what?
Pretend you're walking to the car.
Probably be a better idea if I just went back and rested. That way I don't get caught out at night with my pants down, so to speak. Which one is the fucking map button? Oh, it's R1. Okay. Alright, and I guess if you click the L3 button or the left analog stick, you can sprint.
Getting dark.
Better brighten things up.
I guess that's the fail-safe way to not bring your weapon out.
Not the time for horseplay! My hand slipped.
I like how they react to that. It's pretty funny. Oh yeah, these things right here, you can rent chocobos when you unlock chocobos. Well yeah, right now they don't serve any purpose. But this outpost right here, we can rest in this this fucking camper here. And yeah, lodgings at outposts and in towns cost money, but they provide an experience bonus. And this particular one gives you a 20% experience bonus for only 30 gil. So it's not too bad. It's fairly cost effective, especially if you don't have that much gil. I mean, you get a little bit of an experience bonus. When you camp, you don't get any experience bonuses. However, you still want to camp, obviously, because you want Ignis to level up his cooking and
it's bedtime. Sounds good.
Other things like that. Thank you. Everybody's just gonna kinda hang out and play cards and all that good shit. And yeah, this game actually has the classic victory fanfare, unlike Final Fantasy 13. Yeah, again, I don't... Ooh, yeah, I'm saving this one.
We'll take it.
Yeah, again, I don't really see the... I don't know what pictures I should actually save here. Like, I have no idea.
Perfect timing.
Yeah, the characters will comment on the photos sometimes. Again, I don't know the whole purpose of the whole prompto taking pictures thing. I have no idea. Okay, can't save in certain quests. Whatever, man. It is morning. Speaking of saving. Why the hell not?
Better make tracks.
Chop chop, Prompto.
There in a jiffy!
Oh yeah, cars will stop for you if you run, or they'll try and drive around you if you run out in the middle of the road. They won't run you over, in case you're wondering.
Feels so sluggish.
Yeah.
What are you talking about, man? We just had a good night's sleep. Drink some coffee or something. Something with caffeine in it. I'll wake you up. Those new buttons, man.
Your time has come.
Well, I expected more of a challenge.
Better snap some shots while I've got the chance. Watch this! Never knew why I hit him!
No cause for concern.
Nice. Mission complete.
Who could this be? Hello?
Hey, it's Cindy. How goes the hunting?
Actually, we just finished.
That's great. Cause I got one more hunt for y'all. Only this time, it's for a person. Fella named Dave went off, and we ain't heard from him since. Reckon he staked out a spot in an old shack nearby.
Old shack? Oh, got it. We'll take a look.
Hmm.
So, what did Cindy say?
Needs us to find some Dave guy.
He went missing?
Not missing. Said he's holed up in that shack.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff to find in this world. Like, if you scour, like, everywhere, you will find items all over the fucking place. Like, items that aren't even on the map right now. Like, I mean, you can see some of this shit, right? That you got from the tipster, but you'll find other stuff, too, if you explore enough. Pretty much my whole 20 hours playing this game is just putzing around trying to find as many items as I could.
What's this?
Knocked!
Uh-oh.
Get out of here! You okay?
We are now.
Spoke too soon.
I'm going all out.
Just don't get too carried away. Hear what I'm talking.
No! Get off me.
That's costing me life.
Sorry.
We all good?
Better than good.
Good to go.
Hey, what about the shack over there?
Baddies.
Not yet.
I've got a plan.
Huh. What are we looking at?
This creature is known as a saber tusk.
Yeah, all right.
It skewers prey with its tusks, extracting game from the safety and comfort of burrows.
That's a bit heartless. No one
else. You're mine.
Get off me.
Nice work, Gladio.
Yep.
I'll back you off.
I'm counting on it.
Hey, who's out there? Well, and look who's in here. The man of the hour. Dave, right? Been looking for you.
Didn't mean to cause y'all any trouble. I've been stuck here on account of my sprained ankle. Yeah, something funny about them varmints. I gave them hell, but couldn't finish the job. Still one mean mutt about. Well, y'all don't look much like hunters, but what do you say? Put that puppy to rest for me?
Yeah, let's do it for money, because we're fucking poor as shit.
Sure, we'll do it. Well, for the right price.
Well, you all got guts, that's for sure. Let me tell you where I last saw him.
Phew. For a second, I thought you were gonna forget to ask for cash.
But yeah, when Prompto starts fucking humming the victory fanfare theme after battle, good stuff.
It would be wise to rest up before we set out.
Oh, yeah, status boosting mail, sure. Yeah, why not?
In that case, let's find a spot to make camp.
The hunters are really out in full force around here, huh?
So they're the new Crown's Guard or something?
Similar, though technically a civilian outfit.
They've definitely seen a lot more action than we have.
Is it cool that we rock Crown's Guard outfits?
Be worse not to. They made them especially for us.
Even got a sweet insignia on them.
In the Crown's Guard, your attire identifies you. So wear it with pride.
And we will. Probably a little early to rest up, but fuck it.
We're here.
Let's call it a day.
I'll see what I can whip up.
Gotta love the product placements. Coleman tents. I don't know, man. This game has a lot of soul. A lot more soul than that fucking Disaster 13 trilogy. I'll tell you that. Alright, so I guess I'm gonna go with... why not? I'll just go with this. Better to be safe than sorry. Vegetable medley. Road trip filter? Okay.
Wow.
Perfect timing.
Hey, this one's pretty good.
I know. I dig it too.
So are you supposed to save the pictures that the characters comment on? I'm not really sure how that works. But that's kind of what I'm going to do. I don't know if that's right or not, but that's what I'm going to do.
Like a father to her.
Ever since they got back, Sid's been the only one looking after her.
Rather more than a middling mechanic can handle.
All things considered, I'd say she turned out okay.
Well, like any girl, you just need to treat her right.
Treat her wrong and Sid'll stuff his wrench where the sun don't shine.
Take care of the car and it will take care of us.
Yeah, the car.
Talking about Cindy. You know what they're really thinking about? They're really thinking about motorboating her. That's what they're really thinking about.
feels so sluggish.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's so tempting to fucking go off the beaten path to, like, explore and try and find stuff, but I'm gonna do that later. I just want to focus on the story stuff. Once I get done with the story stuff, then every video I make from then on is just gonna be bonus stuff, exploring, you know, doing hunts, finding items, that kind of thing.
Over there! That's it, right?
Huh. That's a dual horn?
Yes, but not your run-of-the-mill breed.
Ooh.
We'd best make quick work of it.
Look at this guy, huh?
Wait a sec.
What? Scared, big guy?
You ought to be, too. Thing's vicious.
You sure? Looks tame to me.
Yeah.
Look out! Show him who's boss!
Nice one.
It's not over yet.
Ready for round two? Bring it.
Or what?
I'll give you that.
Ring, ring.
Hello?
Hey, Dave just called and said he's safe. Thanks for finding him.
Ken?
Nice work, y'all. By the way, the old girl's looking good as new. She'll be waiting at the garage.
Gotcha.
All right, kick ass.
So, who's up next behind the wheel?
Ignis should take it and never let go.
It helps that he can keep four eyes on the dash.
I couldn't even keep one.
Not sure I'd do any better.
Put me in the driver's seat.
Good. Because I need the legroom in back.
So, Ignis, if Noctis isn't the one driving, you know, you, basically the person who drives so you can just kind of fuck around and not do anything at all is Ignis. He's kind of like the nanny of the party, I guess, would be the best way to describe him. Oh, which way am I going here? Holy fuck. Blackstone Shard.
feel so sluggish.
Indeed.
It's rude to keep a girl waiting. You better apologize. What is that?
Wow.
A live hurricane.
That thing's like half bird, half storm, half airship.
You realize that's three halves.
Would explain its size.
Awesome in every sense.
The sultry.
Yeah. Let's go shopping.
Sounds reasonable enough.
Maybe. I don't know. How am I doing on items?
Are you joining us?
I'm actually doing okay on items. Hey.
Sorry about the wait. Ain't she pretty?
She's almost too pretty for the road.
She's back. We should all get a picture with her.
All the more reason to ride with care. Oh, and before I forget, would y'all mind making a little delivery for me?
Yeah.
No, not at all.
Perfect. Thought you'd say yes. So I already put it in the trunk. There should be a motel on your way to Galdin. If y'all wouldn't mind giving that to the owner, that'd be swell.
Grandpa like grandkid.
Now that she's all polished up and ready for the road, would you care to take her for a little test drive, Noct?
I'm gonna leave it to Ignis, actually, for now.
Not sure I've got what it takes.
I see. Then allow me to take the wheel.
Yeah, I'm thinking at this point in the game, Ignis has got to be the one to drive anyways. Yeah, Ignis won't drive when the demons are out at night. But... I remember once you hit chapter 3, you'll be able to actually choose whether you want Noctis to drive, during the day or at night. But right now, I'm thinking Ignis is the only one that can drive during the day. Ooh. Might as well pick up this shit, huh? Hey, Sid.
Huh. Good. How y'all doing?
Yeah, Yeah, this game reminds me of The Last of Us. I don't know if it's the game engine or the graphics or a combination of both, but it's definitely got a Last of Us vibe to it. Which is a good thing. Which is a really good thing. It's one of the things that actually sold me on this game.
Stinking hot. Indeed.
I was driving.
Hey, what are you after this time?
Yeah, so I do have daggers. What the fu- Oh. Oh, Ignis has them equipped. Duh. Okay. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother with the weapons, because, I think we find weapons anyways, so I'm not too worried about it.
Have yourselves a good browse.
Those are gonna be nice to have. Once we start running into enemies, they can poison you. As far as the other stuff, yeah, I'm not gonna bother.
Please come again.
Don't have enough gil. I saved my gil. Alright, so this is where we're heading, right down here.
Oh, while I gotcha. If y'all want to fix her up before you roll out, let me know. What are y'all after today? What coat do you fancy?
Yeah, I like blue.
Anything in mind for the interior?
Beige. No thanks. Dark rose. Yeah, I like that, actually.
How do you want the wheels?
Let's go with... yeah, metallic gold. Fucking headset was... hold on a minute, man. Yeah, metallic gold, and I can't do anything else.
How's this? I'll polish her up nice for you.
Thanks.
She's all ready for you. Have a look.
All right. Shop. Can shop with, from within the car? Couldn't do this before. This must have been something they added to the game through that day one patch, because that wasn't there before. All right. Well, anyways. Quest location. Let's go.
Everything in order.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah, you can also drive the certain parking spots that have been discovered on your map. You can also choose a custom location.
Hammerhead is like no garage ever. You know?
One would expect no less of purveyors to the crown.
I'll miss it once this road trip's over with.
There's no reason you can't pay them a visit anytime you please. I'm sure Cindy will be glad to look after your car. Oh, right.
So, that's what this is about.
If you need, I could always lend you the regalia.
Whoa! Thanks for the offer, but once we're back in the Crown City, I think I'd better score my own wheels.
Here we go. actually. I don't want to listen to this game's soundtrack. Come on, man. There's some driving music.
Stock up on potions and stuff.
Nice. You're being helpful for a change.
What do you mean for a change?
You all came all the way out here to deliver the goods. Well, thank you kindly. We'll take it out of the trunk, so you all just sit tight.
Umbra.
Bringing us stuff. Attaboy.
A dog can really track a scent.
Certainly knows how to find us.
How do you always know, boy?
Just a sec.
Nice flower. It's the same kind we sewed our crowns from. Oh yeah, sill blossoms. So, I have a favor to ask. Take the notebook with you when you go.
Sure.
That's not all. I want you to put something in the book and send it back.
I think it matters which one of these you put, so I guess this. I don't know.
All set. Take care out there.
I know. You're not gonna tell me.
Then don't ask.
What was that about? You don't say.
Now that our work's done, let's see ourselves to Galdin.
Alright, so we're gonna head to Galdin Quay, but I think I'm gonna wait for the next video to do that, so I hope you've enjoyed. Actually, hold on.
Hold on a sec, sir.
What?
I found an envelope addressed to Meldacio inside the package.
Meldacio? The Hunter HQ?
Yes, sir. The headhunter ought to be around here somewhere. Mind making one more delivery?
What do you say, Noct? Might as well while we're in the neighborhood.
Yeah, all right. I don't care about side quests right now. Again, I'll do that stuff later. But yeah, I'm going to wait till the next episode. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next. Bye-bye.